Facts First presents. After beloved wife's death, husband discovers the elaborate lie she lived for decades. Most married couples know just about everything there is to know about each other. And over time, spouses meet each other's friends, family members, even old classmates. Many couples have no secrets about their past, and they like it that way. But that was not the way that Blake Ruff's marriage was at all. His marriage was full of secrets. He just didn't know until the very end. In 2003, Blake Ruff met Lori Erica Kennedy at a Bible class in Texas. As soon as he saw Lori, he was instantly attracted to her. Lori told Blake that she was originally from Arizona, but she didn't say much more than that about herself. She never opened up to him, but he told her everything about himself. He was in love, so the fact that she was a private person didn't bother him. It did, however, bother Blake's family. His family didn't trust Lori right from the start. They found it strange that she had no family and no friends. She never talked about her past or anyone in her past. Blake was the only person in her life, it appeared, and this raised some serious suspicions. Blake, however, was blinded by love, and in 2004, he and Lori were married in a private ceremony. The preacher who officiated the ceremony was the only person in attendance. Blake and Lori dreamed of starting a family, but it wasn't as easy as they had hoped. Over the years, Lori suffered from multiple miscarriages. The miscarriages were hard on both Blake and Lori, so the couple decided to try IVF to conceive a child and expand their family. Finally, Lori found out that she was pregnant with a little girl. Their dreams had finally come true. Blake believed that his life was finally on the right path. Unfortunately for Blake, though, things were about to go downhill. Fast. Blake and Lori's daughter was born in 2008, and it should have been a time for celebration, but it wasn't. It was actually the opposite. Lori became even more distant and private. She was also overprotective of her daughter to the point of obsession. She was so bad that she never even let Blake's mother hold their daughter. Well, this made his family very angry, which is understandable. And it started to get Blake pretty upset, too. His family became more and more suspicious of Lori than ever before. They knew something wasn't right about their son's wife. When Lori refused to let Blake's family even see their daughter, the tension got even worse. Blake and Lori's marriage was obviously in trouble, and Lori fell into a deep depression. She had no friends, no family, and nobody in her life except for Blake, and now she was pulling away from him. She didn't even let Blake's family in, so she wasn't close to them. Being alone all the time with nobody to talk to, it took its toll on Lori. Blake and Lori tried to save what was left of their marriage. They had a child together who deserved to have parents in the home. In 2010, they went to counseling to try and make things better. During counseling, Blake realized that Lori wasn't the person he fell in love with years earlier, and he realized that the marriage was entirely over. He decided to file for divorce the following spring. This did not sit well with Lori, and her depression worsened. She lost weight, stopped taking care of herself, and spent hours rambling to her church's pastor about her problems, but she never got to the point. On Christmas Eve, 2010, Lori drove to Blake's parents' house and parked in the front. She shot herself in the head. Blake's father found her on Christmas morning, along with a suicide note for Blake and their daughter. But nobody could understand either one of them. The family wanted to find out who this woman was and what she was hiding. Things got more intense when Blake found papers in his home that proved that Lori had once changed her name. Her name used to be Becky Sue Turner. When it was discovered, though, that the real Becky Sue Turner died in a fire in 1971 at the age of 2, an investigation began. Investigators ran her fingerprints, but they found nothing. Nobody knew who this woman was. When an investigator took a DNA sample from Lori's daughter, they found a distant relative. As soon as Blake heard about this connection, he got on a plane and went to speak with this family member of Lori. The relative said that the woman's name was actually Kimberly McLean. She disappeared from her family's home when she was 17 years old when her mother married a man that she hated. Unfortunately, nobody knew anything about her after that. Blake has finally accepted that he'll never find out anything about his ex-wife's past. All he can do now is raise his daughter and make sure that she has a long and happy life. The mystery will be with Blake forever. But so will his daughter's love. Subscribe for more.